Doma Sports Talk, worldwide, with some news for the world of tennis. So y'all check this out. Well, we're in the French Open. And what I got to say is Groundhog Day or something. Rafael Nadal has reached the final of the French Open. I mean, people like clicked off already and turned and like, you know, man, I thought you had some news. You know what I mean? I thought you had some news, man. What you telling me? Rafael Nadal is in the final of the French Open. I mean, man, get out of here with that. So what? You know what I'm saying? That's how bad it's getting with Rafael Nadal getting into these finals of the French Open. This is about 11 of them, y'all. Okay? People don't win nothing 11 times. Nothing. Who wins anything 11 times? Your name ain't Bill Russell or something. You ain't winning nothing 11 times. Right? Unless you lying about your story. You know the stories you told about 20 years ago and nobody was there that you telling it to? And you can say you won something. Like, I won marbles, man, 11 times on the block because nobody messed with me. You don't win nothing 11 times. Rafael Nadal is in the final of the French Open for the 11th time. It's ridiculous. We were trying to find superlatives for him last year and Roger Federer, too. Let's not get it twisted. Roger Federer doing his thing, trying to win Wimbledon 9 times. Ridiculous. But this is the best clay court player by so far. It's ridiculous. You know, when you're talking about Roger Federer and Wimbledon, you know, somebody might push up on him. Bjorn Borg might push up on him a little bit. You know, Pete Sampras definitely going to push up on him. He's going to push him once. You know, now Federer going to push back a time or two. But Pete Sampras definitely push him once. Right? But ain't nobody pushing Rafael Nadal on clay. At all. Never. You know what I'm talking about? Ever, probably. It's ridiculous. That he's in because, you know, the French Open, which is the best 3 out of 5, baby? On clay. And it's like, I went all them other tournaments too. You know, a lot of them. Rome, Madrid, Barcelona, Monte Carlo. What? He won them all. And a whole lot of times. I think Monte Carlo is the one he won less. It's by like 7. All the other ones is 9, 10, 11. It's incredible. This guy is an alien on this surface. He's in the final. Now, he's going to deal with Dominic Thiem. Dominic Thiem has been doing his thing. Because Dominic Thiem, you know, is the dude who beat him on clay this year. And don't many people can say you beat Rafael Nadal on clay. Okay? You know, can't say that unless you're playing something else. Oh, I played him in some soccer on clay and I beat him. But you're not, if it's tennis on clay, you know, Dominic Thiem, that was probably, if you ask him for real, what's his biggest win to date? I'm telling you, that's in the top 3 or 2 probably for Dominic Thiem in his life. Because you just don't beat him on clay. Now, Dominic Thiem is in the final again to make sure people know that's no fluke. So the final is probably the best 2 on clay at this particular time. Now, Rafael Nadal beat my boy, Del Potro. And Del Potro getting to the semifinals on clay is something y'all better be careful about. Soon we get Wimbledon, he might get to the semifinals again. But when we get to U.S. Open, he's one of my favorites. Okay? Because he's back and his wrists are okay and somebody in trouble. But on clay, you ain't messing with Rafael Nadal. 11 times. Okay? I was sleeping. I was chilling. But it's 2 things that made me have to get up. It was a video I had to do about Kubrat Pulev. If y'all don't know what it is, like I'm talking tennis, you don't know. But Rafael Nadal in the final for the 11th time is the biggest news of the day. And it's just awesome. And you guys give me some more superlatives for this creature. Because this is ridiculous. Go ahead, Rafa. Vamanos! Vamos! Doma Sports Talk. Worldwide. And I'm about here, y'all.